Alrighty guys, this is me, the Almighty Dieter from YouTube, and I have no idea why I did this to myself. Didn't really want one. I seen that they were in stock. Ran to the store, and I got one, long story short. I also ordered one online, and hopefully it doesn't get delivered because I don't have to return it. Because it just seemed like they were in stock and there's a shortage. Now with the shortage, my old Switch, the fan has been kind of loud. So I'm going to sell this thing. I don't know when. I can sell it to GameStop, to anybody. Sure, I can make a good like 200, maybe 220. I had gift credit at Best Buy anyway. So I got 25 bucks off this technically. I sell this. It's probably like a $100 upgrade. Whatever. It is a launch model Switch. I do cherish it. There's nothing special about it. Except the Joy-Cons. I did get these cool Joy-Cons. I'm going to regret having to sell these with that. But I'm not going to give them my Skyward Sword Joy-Cons, nor will I give them the white one, because this will match the dock anyway. So, let's get to unboxing it. I have it out for a size comparison, and I'm also trying to hide the serial number if it shows on the box. So, kind of gotta hide it. So, you open the box. There you have it. Switch Joy-Cons. I'm pretty sure they'll fit any Switch from this version to the old version. I don't think it's bigger in size. If it is, it's marginally bigger. It should work universally with any Switch. I don't know if they're rounded off more or not. It does feel a little different, maybe because they're brand new. But as you see here, same concept. They're Joy-Cons, nothing too crazy. Hopefully, I don't know, something feels different about them. Stick feels heavier. Could be because they're whatever. So I'm going to take this out. I got two of them right here. I got this, and then you have the Switch itself, which this is kind of heavier. It does have a better stand, so that's pretty cool. Heavier, has an OLED screen and less bordered rims. So we'll show a comparison of it in a second. I just want to kind of have it side by side with it. Might be marginally bigger, like I said. I do know the screen is bigger, but overall, it looks like, honestly, it looks like it's the same size. It's just it has a bigger screen. Yeah, it feels like it's a little heavier, it's a little wider, not by much, but it also just has a bigger screen in it. So I'm going to do the system transfer. I need to get a screen protector for this. This boy has given me so many memories, so, you know, I do cherish this system overall. So we're going to check out what else is inside of it. The dock is actually a super dock, more or less. So let's take out the super dock right here. It comes with, obviously, HDMI. Comes with a new charger, which I don't know if it's any different. And then in here, it comes with like the little controller thing, which I almost never use because I hate it. So I'll probably give this to the person I'm selling it to, unless it looks different, which I can't tell if it does or not. Because I probably won't be able to find mine. And they'll probably be like, where is it? Or probably not. So we're kind of doing this messy. the white dock is actually really nice. Opens up. Which way does it open? Probably gonna break this in half. Oh, it just pops off like that, I think. I don't know if that was supposed to happen. But as you see here, AC adapter, HDMI out, LAN cable. Didn't have that on the original dock. I'm not gonna pull it out. But this is pretty sleek, I gotta say, this dock. I wasn't really expecting it. And this is gonna be next to my PS5, which is white. So that'll be kind of cool to look at. But this is what it looks like overall, which is kind of awesome. Kind of looks like it wiggles a lot more, which is a little weird. Power adapter, nothing new. Looks like they changed the wrist straps on these. I could be crazy. I'm pretty sure they were just solid black. Now they got little white stripes on them. And then right here, this will tell us if the Joy-Cons are slightly different dimensions, which I don't think they are. They actually might be. Look at that groove. I mean, they still fit, but like, look at the groove. So that's what it kind of looks like. I'm kind of curious if the groove is filled with the gap with this. No. I mean, I really can't tell the difference. I'm pretty sure they're the same. But anyway, guys, this is more or less the Switch OLED. I got to do a system transfer, so that's going to be very exciting. My first time doing that. And yeah, I'm very excited. I mean, you got the ports for the new kickstand, which is a lot more solid. The SD card hides right here, which I wish they had like a little cover for it. I guess this is the cover. I almost never use the stand, but you can literally stand it almost any way now. So that's really cool. It actually might be more useful as opposed to this little rinky dink leg thing that only goes this way and barely holds. You know, it's like very wobbly. But see, I mean, the SD card has always been shown, but that's pretty much it. But I'm very excited, guys, which is crazy because I was trolling the hell out of people who were upgrading. And then here I am. I mean, here we go. You know, it's Splatoon 2 I trolled. What else did I troll? I don't know. I've trolled many things and then I turn out to be wrong. But, you know, I'm a big Nintendo fan. I felt like I should have done it. And yeah, I'm going to sell this boy. Hopefully I could profit sort of off of it. Well, not really profit, but almost get a free upgrade, which I doubt. But yeah, let me know down below if you upgraded. If not, why not? I mean, I don't really blame you because originally I was not going to. But yeah, very excited to see if this treats me any different. And the battery's a lot better. This old model battery was kind of trash anyway, even when I first got it. So, I mean, it's very exciting that I'll be able to play games probably 5 to 6 hours without having to charge it now. But again, this is me, the Almighty D, Aragon from YouTube. Deuces. I'm outie.